what shall I say more? Time would fail me to tell of these men. Very often as we're reading through the Bible, we come to great sections of the Word of God that are nothing more than lists of names. And they encourage us to remember that God notices the individual. At the time of reading, it seems a bit bleak. As they say, Chronicles is a bit like the phone book. You know, it has a great cast, but not much plot. But apart from the prophetic reasons, I think there are good practical reasons to recognize that God notices the individual. We often don't, but He does, and He knows them. And He reminds us, as we read through a chapter like Hebrews 11, that someone's watching. When David, as a young lad, was out on the backside of the desert looking after a few sheep, and a lion came, and another occasion a bear came, and many a young man would say, well, I'm glad to look after my father's sheep, but I'm not going to jeopard my life for some little lamb. I mean, sheep have more sheep, I'll just write it off as a business expense. But he loved that particular lamb, and so he went after it. And that happened to be the day God was looking for a king. And God says, I can use a young man like that. A young man who cares for the particular lambs in the flock. And so, as we discover time and time again, these individuals that are recorded for us, we only see the highlights of their life, but in between these great mountaintop experiences, there were long periods of time of just going on with God, plodding away at the life of faith. And sometimes we think that the life of faith all ought to be written in neon lights. Doodly-doo-doo-doo, here they are again, ladies and gentlemen. And today we live in a world, especially the Christian community, that writes all of these great autobiographies and biographies of sparkling lives, and we think, oh, wouldn't it be great to be like that? But you know, God isn't looking for superstars. God is looking for ordinary people that will let God be great through them. And that's really Hebrews 11. When you read of David's mighty men, the fact is that these men weren't all that mighty. It was just that they stuck around for the battle. They didn't take off. Because we read the common refrain in the history of these mighty men, and the Lord wrought a great victory that day. It was the Lord who wrought the victory. They just stuck around for it. They stayed for the battle. Everyone else took off, and they decided to stick it out. Now, I'd really like to encourage you to stick it out. It's not easy going. And there are many struggles and problems. And basically, as we read through the section, we discover that all of these people had good reason to bail out. They had good reason to be discouraged, to give up. But they didn't give up, and they carried on for God. It's the person who is committed to the life of faith, who sees beyond the obvious, who has the long view of things, that sticks it out, that stays at his post. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him.